my whole wheat gingerbread cookies for my coworkers, just for the holidays. And what says holidays better than gingerbread? Now they think I'm just bringing them a sweet treat, but in reality, I swapped out the whole wheat flour instead of all-purpose flour. So it's just my way of getting a little bit of healthy into their holidays. Our dry ingredients into one bowl and then our wet into another. So we have our whole wheat flour, our sugar, baking soda and salt, and all of our yummy spices. And then you just whisk all the dry ingredients together. And this whisk is perfect for my holiday baking because my granny gave it to me last Christmas to use, and she just inspires me in all the food that I make. And now we're going to put all of our wet ingredients into this bowl. So we're going to take our molasses, put that in there. And then we want our olive oil. And then before we beat it together, we're going to add in a couple spoonfuls of our dry mixture, just to help it kind of mix together a little better. Just like that. And we get our beater, and you're going to beat it for about a minute on medium speed. And then once that's well and combined, we add the egg in and beat it for another minute. And now we're going to take our dry ingredients and we're going to slowly combine them into our wet as we beat them on medium until it's nice and combined. And don't forget to scrape the sides to make sure that all the dry ingredients get mixed in. So once your dough is all mixed, it should look something like this. And then you're just going to take a small handful and you're going to form it into a nice little ball. And then you're going to finish it in this mixture, which is just the zest of two oranges and then sugar in the raw. I guess it's just a nice little crunch when it comes out of the oven, and it's really delicious. So once you do that, you just place it on your baking sheet. After about 12 or 13 minutes, your cookies should be good to go and look something like this. Then all you have to do is just place them on a cooling rack for a couple minutes, and then you're ready to enjoy this holiday healthy version of a holiday classic.